Good morning. I don't know which light I got going on here because that sun is blasting right in my face. But today I really just want to do two things. One, I want to test this microphone, which is up here. And two, I want to talk about this little Chuwi Hi10 Air. And basically it's a 2-in-1 tablet. Now you've probably seen these before. A friend of mine bought this and I think he paid like 200 bucks for it from ThinkGeek or someplace like that. And then we did a bit of trading and wheeling and dealing and all that. So this actually might cost me $40, which is worth 40 bucks. I wouldn't put much more into it. Well, it might be worth 100 bucks. It's hard to say, but it's running the, where the hell did the processor go? X5-Z8350, 4 gigs of RAM. None of this is upgradable, and a 64 gig SSD built into it. And it does have expansion with a micro USB port. So I thought we'd do a quick little tour of it, take a look at it. It's not so bad, actually. I mean, it might be my new couch laptop. I haven't decided yet. Or I might sell it. I don't know yet. I haven't given it much thought. It's a little bit difficult to use if you don't have a full-size keyboard and mouse. So let's dive into it and see how it turned out.
Yes, I know my desk is a mess. I apologize for that. But let's take a little dive into this Chuwi. So like I said, this is the H10 Air. I believe that is what they call it. I think there's actually an H10 Air and an H10 Pro. And I believe that the difference is that the Pro comes with a pen built in here somewhere, but the Air does not. Okay, so let's take a quick look at this guy. Like I said, it does have an Atom processor. It has a webcam. On this side over here, we have a speaker. You will need storage, so it has a micro SD slot. This is your USB Type-C. This is your charging port, and I believe you can also plug peripherals into it. That is a mini HDMI. I think that is your microphone. Mini USB, headphone microphone jack. And this here is a regular USB. I don't know if it's USB 3.0 or 2.0, but let's assume it's a 3. On the front here, we have your power switch. Over here, we have your volume up, volume down rocker. Nothing along here. Over here, we have this beautiful dent. This is where my friend dropped it. He says he didn't drop it, but look at that. That is horrible. Now, this does have an aluminum body, which is actually really solid and makes it pretty hefty. So it was able to absorb a lot of that brunt. On this side here, we have the other speaker and another USB. On the back, we have nothing. These here, two plastic things, are used for when you pop up the LCD. It gives it a bit of lift, just enough. And I guess that's so that whatever you're lifting it on rubs here as opposed to the metal. Now it's a little flimsy, as you can see there. But keep in mind that this does pop right off. And these are extremely strong magnets. You can see. And you can see there's the port for connecting the two devices. It's actually really quite durable. I'm seriously debating whether or not I want to get rid of this. It does have a window key here, which is a soft button, I guess you could say, or a hard button. So that when I press that, when the machine is on, it actually reverts back to Windows. Like it clears the screen. Has a pretty fast boot up. I'm actually pretty impressed with it. But then again, it is just a 64 gig SSD. Like I said, the keyboard is a little small, but fun fact, it has an insert key. See that right there? Insert. You know it doesn't have an insert key? This Lenovo X240. No insert key. And a horrible trackpad. But more on that later. Okay, so you see it boots into Windows. It is a touch screen since it's a tablet. Don't mind my password, it's very complicated. 11:22, is that the real time? It is. Now, it's pretty responsive as far as, well, what it has. As I said, it is the Atom X5-Z8350 processor at 1.44 gigahertz. 4 gigs of RAM installed, and it comes with Windows 10, currently running version 18.03. I have no interest in updating this right now because I don't know what I'm going to do with it. But like I said, when you take this button here and you press it, it reverts back to Windows. And obviously you can use it in this mode or in tablet mode. It's a pretty responsive touchpad. It is quite small, so it requires a bit of effort. And the keyboard is just slightly smaller than anything else. So when I do use this machine, I almost prefer to use a full-size keyboard just for giggles. Now it browses pretty quickly. It's not perfect. And then when you put it in tablet mode, say, do you want to switch to tablet mode? Let's choose yes. So now it's just in tablet mode. And like I said, it's pretty smooth. You could do a lot worse for this kind of money, I'll say that much. For the money that my friend paid for it, the $200, what can you buy that's comparable? You might get a used iPad. You might buy an Android tablet. There's one for comparison. This is the Google Nexus 10. But when it comes to the price of this, I think for the $200, it's actually a really good deal. You're not going to find much in its price market that can compare. Plus, it's a 1200 resolution screen. How crazy is that? Also keep in mind that Windows does occupy almost half of this unit's storage. Like I said, it has 64 gigs of storage. Windows takes up about 25 gigs. So that is why you're going to want to use the micro SD storage. So as you can see the partitions here, it has a recovery partition of 1000 meg. Windows is 57 gigs, and then it has this little partition 1. Very interesting though. Does come with like mini office installed. Do you call it mini office? Well, I can log into it using my Outlook.com account, but I don't plan on it. Like I said, I may just end up selling this machine, so. And now that we're connected, it's like, do you want to exit tablet mode? Yes, I would like to exit tablet mode. So now we're in regular Windows mode, and you can see that when I do a right click, or attempt to do a right click here, so I'm going to go into Display Properties, look at that resolution, 1920 by 1200, that's better than this X240 over here. It's actually even better than my T450S. And like I said, when you plug in the USB Type-C cable, it goes into charging mode. 85%, no, it's not so bad. Plugged in for better performance. On battery. You know, I wish that snapped in there like a magnet like the MacBook has. But it's still pretty responsive. Okay, front-facing camera, that's me. Rear-facing camera. That's not too bad. A little choppy. How big my hand is. Zooms in pretty well though, I would say. Can I zoom in even further? It gets a little pixelated. Front facing camera again. There's me. There's you. Can you see that with the glare? Now, would I buy this for $200? Yeah, I'd buy it for $200. I don't think I'd buy it for $300, though. That's getting a little out of my price range. Okay, so if you have any questions on it, leave it in the comments below. I can't guarantee how long I'm going to have this for. It might be for sale sooner than you think. But for now, I would rate this as a definite buy. This is something you want to spend your money on when you're looking at like used tablets. I don't think you're going to find much better of a deal out there. The problem with these kind of tablets, with Windows tablets, is obviously you will not be playing Android Play games, or you won't be playing games that you're going to find in the Apple iOS store. This is mainly for surfing. I mean, there's not a lot of games that Windows will have in here that you can play. At least in my own personal opinion. But if you just use it for Facebook and websites and emails and stuff like that, I think you'll be fairly happy with it. Actually, emails you might have a bit of an issue with because of the keyboard. But like I said, if you have any questions, leave them in the comments below. Thanks for watching. Hit that subscribe button. That's right here. And we shall talk again. Thanks for watching.
Chuwi.